Welcome back. We are here to continue the conversation about change and what can we do in our lives to make sure that we are living the best and most vital life we can. And our next guest, Leanne DeSanto, is doing just that. She has a terrific story that brings her to her current life, and she's going to share that with all of us right now. Leanne, thank you for being here.
Thank you so much. I'm really excited to be here.
We're excited to have you.
Yeah.
So you've got a great backstory. You did a lot of cool stuff that most of us would never do. So tell us, you were a professional bodybuilder?
Not professional, okay. But I was a regional bodybuilder. I competed when I lived in Atlanta and when I lived in Chicago.
Okay, and a competitive bodybuilder.
Yeah, and then I went on to compete in national fitness shows, which involved an obstacle course, kind of before American Ninja Warrior became popular.
This is amazing!
So I was climbing ropes and cargo nets, and a while ago, but which suited me because I was a track athlete growing up, so I was more suited for that than I was the gymnastics type routines in the fitness world. So did a few of those competitions, and that was so fun. And
what was your favorite part of the obstacle course? What did you just kill it on?
I like the monkey bars.
Really?
Yeah. Wow. I like the tires. We ran through tires and jumped over hurdles and cargo nets. So the wall of the rope was probably the hardest.
That is just fantastic. I have a friend who is currently getting ready to compete in her first show, and she is just like spending hours and hours at the gym. She looks incredible,
right?
She would have to,
but
it's really, I understand how intense it is. That is just such an amazing accomplishment.
Thank you. Yeah, it's a lot of work, but I love the journey part of it. Mm-hmm. You know, it was once the show day, it was like whatever happens. You know,
right.
It was just like committing to that goal and following through. Mm-hmm. So
absolutely,
so it was a lot of fun. Yeah,
and that has informed your current business and what you're doing right now.
Yeah, so I was competing. I was in the fitness world. I came out of my undergrad with biology, chemistry, and I was like, what am I going to do with that? And decided I wanted to go into personal training and competed and got my master's in exercise physiology.
Okay.
And again, I was like, okay, what do I want to do? Do I want to not do cardiac rehab or get people before the heart attack? You know, do more of the preventative. Don't get them after, but let's get them before. So so did that for 25 years all over the country. So trained in different gyms, different from in-home to corporate wellness, did that.
Wow.
And and landed here in California in 1998. And opened my own facility and ran that for 8 years, a private training facility in Corona Del Mar.
Oh, wow.
So that was a lot of fun. And you know, just being able to see the people, you know, coming in, like, kind of dreading the workout, you know, and then leaving, just feeling like $1 million bucks.
I feel like that sometimes. I have this cute 15-year-old daughter that's 5'11", and she's on the track team, and she actually broke the triple jump record at her high school. I'm so proud.
Wow.
But she drags me to the gym at night. And I never want to go, but she can't drive yet, right? So she's like, just drive me there. And then I get there, and she's like, just come in.
Right.
And I'm like, okay. And by the time I leave, I love it. I needed it.
Yeah. But you never regret a workout, right?
Never regret it.
It's hard to get started, though.
It is hard for me to get started sometimes. And so I totally respect and admire that. So.
And then in the spirit of your current business, so that is perfect because it's all about eat, think, move, right?
So talk to us
about what you're doing now.
So from being in the fitness world for so long and being competitive myself and also going through my own struggles, because bodybuilding really lends itself to yo-yo dieting, right? It's deprivation dieting. It's like you're killing it for 14 to 16 weeks before your show, and then when the show's over, it's over. I mean, you are just binge eating, you know, because that's what it sets you up, because you're just tired of being hungry.
Yeah.
So it's and a lot of women have experienced not that, but yo-yo dieting, right? It's like doing something to maybe get ready for a reunion or get ready for something, you know, crushing it, and then all of a sudden it's like, oh my God, I'm so tired, you know, then rebounding. So so through my own experience, I learned that, and then I saw that happening with some of my clients too. And I saw a couple things when I had my studio, was that I would tell them what to do, show them what to do, they'd work with me for the 3 hours out of the week, but then they just couldn't seem to do it on their own, right? Like, we know what to do, but we just can't seem to do it. Or I'd see people that would come in and you know, do everything, get some great results, but still hate parts of their body. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So I saw two things happening, and I was like, okay, wait a minute. It's more than just me saying, you know, eat this way, move this way. It's really how you think and your beliefs and your mindset. So that's what shifted me to go deeper in that training.
Mm-hmm. And so how do you work with clients now?
Well, right now I work with clients. I don't personal train clients anymore. Mm-hmm. I do more kind of holistic life coaching. Okay. So some come through the fitness door and want that, and want to get in touch with their body, love their bodies more, make the physical changes they want to make, but do it in a just a more graceful way. Mm-hmm. You know, not killing themselves and deprivation and all this kind of, because most of us work out because we hate our body, not because we love our body.
What a great mindset shift. That's so insightful.
That's such an interesting statement.
Yeah. So when we do it from a place of loving our body, yes, we might have little things we want to change, but it just changes the intention of everything. Mm-hmm. And then I think it's easier for our body to release what it needs to release. You know, because sometimes our body holds on to extra body fat or extra, you know, and then the more stress we're under, we're actually working against us.
Sure. Yeah. Inflammation kicks in.
Because cortisol, the stress hormone, really tracks with insulin. So you would get all that hormonal stuff. And then it's what happens when you get too much insulin in the body is that you're craving sweets. And you're craving, so everything you're fighting against is there. Yeah. So it's really challenging.
That is so interesting. So back to my daughter for a minute. So I remember at that age, because she's like very, you know, self-conscious about how she looks. And I just wish I could go back to when I was her age and be like, you look great. Just enjoy it now. You know what I mean? And like age tells you, you know, gives you a lot of perspective. But I think about that, and then I think of, and then I think also, you know, when I look at my friends and the people that I love and the people I want to spend time with, do I care at all whether they have a flaw on their body? No. And so I try to like internalize that for myself too. Like the people who love me are not going to take a look at me and be like, oh, she looks like she's gained 5 pounds this week.
Right.
And so, but it's hard to get out of that mindset.
I've been meaning to talk to you about that.
hold on. I mean, need to revise my opinion.
Never asked why I look fat in that dress, right?
But it is about mindset, and it's the self-talk, and it's the self-think, and and then it's the it's actually the triggers of knowing what to do. So, you know,
absolutely,
we can have people tell us until we're blue in the face, don't think that way, or think this way, or do this. But you have three things we can do to rev up our metabolism, and I know that personally, a revved metabolism changes everything. If my body is moving internally, my brain is moving, my just everything feels more on and more clear, and if I know everything's working, because that's what we're after,
and
right?
Just feel sharp.
Is getting everything to work and feel that sharpness. So what are the three things, because I know, I don't know what they are, but I know they're not what I think they are.
They're not what they think they are, exactly.
Okay, what are they? I've been dying to know.
Okay. So a couple, I'm a bit of a science nerd, so just a little bit about science is that we have the autonomic nervous system, and we have two branches of that, the sympathetic and the parasympathetic.
Okay.
So the sympathetic is our fight, flight, or freeze. That's the amygdala that's like,
I've got to go.
Yeah, that's the saber-toothed tiger is chasing me.
Okay.
I need to...
There are lots of those in Newport Beach. I run away all the time.
And the parasympathetic is the rest and digest. So we really digest in the parasympathetic state when we're relaxed. But what happens is most of us are living in this chronic low-level stress,
fight or
Fight or flight. The tiger's not chasing us, but the definition of stress is any real or imagined threat. So we're putting all this stuff in our head, right? Whether it's, do I have enough money? Do I look good enough? Is my kids going to be able to get to college? All of these things, all this worry causes this low-level stress. And if we're eating under stress, we're not digesting our food. So the three things that I recommend people do before they sit down to a meal is, without even really talking about the food that they're eating, it's who are they as an eater? How are they showing up? So the first thing is breathing. Taking 5 to 10 deep breaths, because that will shift you from the sympathetic to the parasympathetic, where you can take the deep breaths and just relax, invite oxygen to the meal, and just relax before you start. And then the second one is to slow down. Because even if we're eating the healthiest food in the world, if we're eating it too fast, it's a stressor on the body.
That's true. Got it. That's so funny.
And I'm a fast eater. You guys are fast eaters.
Oh, yeah.
I'm totally
like
fast eater.
Wolf stuff down. Yeah, of course.
Totally fast eater, I know.
Wolf down my PBJ in between meetings.
Well, because you got someplace to be.
Yeah.
Right. Someplace to go.
But I love this, like, slow down to speed up your metabolism.
Yeah, it's exactly what it is. And it's so, you know, and it sounds so common sense. Okay, yeah, right. But how many of us do it?
You
know?
No, deep breath. Deep breaths.
Deep breath, slow down. Whatever that
what's
looks
the third
like.
One?
The third one is be present.
Okay.
So when you can really be present at your meal time, and with anything really, these three things work with.
Sure.
Before a tough conversation, before you have so many things. If you can breathe, slow down, and be present, it just puts you in the mindset. So you're more aware of what's happening. Because I don't know if this has ever happened to you guys, but for me, I've eaten a meal and then literally. Like, don't even remember chewing.
Right.
Did I even eat that meal?
No, I totally get it. Because you're, like, totally distracted about what you were just doing or what you've got to do in 2 hours.
Right. You're watching the news. That's stressful. You're, you know.
Yeah, absolutely.
Things that we shouldn't be doing.
You're right. Those were not the ones I thought would be to speed up your metabolism.
But they all speed up our metabolism. They increase our digestion. They alleviate a lot of digestive issues that people have. Uh-huh. You know, it's really just slowing down. And just being aware, just bringing awareness to the meal.
Makes sense.
You know? Yeah.
How do we get in touch with you to get some life coaching?
LeanneDeSanto.com.
Okay.
Or Leanne at LeanneDeSanto.com.
Okay.
And my phone number is everywhere on all my social media.
Okay.
And Leanne DeSanto is pretty much on all the social media.
We'll put that up on the screen.
Yeah, totally.
Leanne, thank you so much for coming in. We so appreciate the information.
It was so fun to talk with
you. We'll look forward to seeing you again.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you.
And we'll be right back.